What's up guys, quick disclaimer here. After you install both Voicemeeter and virtual audio cable, you will have to do separate restarts for your computer, so just be warned of that. One last thing before we start the video. Once you start this process, you will not be able to hear system audio again until you finish the process. So go ahead and transfer this video over to your phone or to your TV or your tablet or whatever, because in a second here, you won't be able to hear me. First off, you're going to want to download Voicemeeter. To do that, you just want to open Chrome or whatever browser you have installed and search Voicemeeter Bannana. For this, we're going to be using Voicemeeter Bannana instead of Voicemeeter. Okay, once you're on the Voicemeeter page, all you want to do is scroll down and then click the download for the EXE. Then you want to scroll back up afterwards, go to Virtual Audio Cable, and download the Windows version of that as well. Then, after doing that, you want to drag them both to your desktop, and then run the Voicemeeter setup. After running the Voicemeeter setup and finishing it, it's going to ask you to restart your computer, so go ahead and do that now. Now that you've restarted your computer, you can install Virtual Audio Cable. Go ahead and do that now. Then, once you do that, you'll have to restart one more time. Now that you've restarted your PC for the last time, we can go on to setting up Voicemeeter. Now, setting up Voicemeeter honestly isn't that hard. To set it up, first you're going to want to open Voicemeeter. Then go to the bottom right and open your sound settings, and then make sure your output is set to the correct output, which is cable input, virtual audio cable. Make sure it's that one and nothing else. Once that's selected, go back to Voicemeeter and make sure you have your headphones selected for the A1 category. That'll be the hardware out. That's where your sound's gonna end up going. It doesn't really matter what you use, just make sure you pick your headphones. There's a few different hardware inputs here. I just have one set for my mic and one set for system. Don't worry about the mic. Just set one of them for the cable output. That way you can hear your system audio through Voicemeeter. And if you right click it, you can go ahead and change it to whatever name you want to name it. And just make sure A1 is ticked. That way you can hear it. Now you have your Discord and your music categories as well. To start off, we'll go over Discord. Go over to your voice and video settings on Discord and just make sure you change your output to voice input VB audio voice. Make sure you don't change it to Voicemeeter aux. It has to be Voicemeeter input. If you change it to aux, this will not work. You have to make sure it's Voicemeeter input. Now, once you do that, it'll be fully integrated with Voicemeeter and you can rename it or do whatever you want. Once again, just make sure your A1 is ticked on Voicemeeter. And then lastly, Google Chrome, how to get your music integrated with Voicemeeter as well in its own little audio channel. For this, you're going to want to right click and open sound settings again. And you're going to want to scroll all the way down to advanced sound options and go to app volume and device preferences. For some reason, my Chrome doesn't show up here, but you just want to go to Chrome and change your output to your Voicemeeter aux input. Instead of the Voicemeeter input, we're going to do Voicemeeter aux input right here. You're going to want to go to your sources, add, and you're going to want to add an audio input device. You can see here I have a folder that I call audio for my music and my Discord sources. That's how they pop up right there in the bottom right in the sound mixer. This way I can just turn them off easily in game by just alt tabbing out and turning them off in OBS, and the stream can't hear them and I still can. So to do that, just insert an audio output capture, and mine's already in use because I already have the folder set up, but you get the gist. Set up the audio output capture for Voicemeeter aux, Voicemeeter input, and your system on OBS should already be your virtual audio cable. So once you do all that, you should be good to go. Thank you guys so much for watching the video, and I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget that I Twitch stream zombies as well as sim racing, typically every weekend and most weekdays on my Twitch, CNDR_Dragon. So go ahead and leave a like on the video and follow my Twitch. If you didn't like the video, go ahead and tell me why in the comments. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And now, I'm gonna leave you guys off with some Mob of the Dead gameplay from Black Ops 2 Zombies. Everybody have a good one, and I hope you enjoyed.
seen this box before. Gives you weapons like a slot machine. Once again, we only delay the inevitable.
Ain't about
my fire, ain't I? Just I didn't Billy Wood. This'll be over soon unless I get some slugs. You don't want to bite me. I'm rotten to the core.
No way.
Again with the money. Why? We're thieves. Let's steal it. We all gotta go sometime. You just went now.
Double points.
That'll do. Well, okay. Kim's McLoving me right now. I feel you, baby.
What do you play?
Call of Duty Black Ops 2.